Her variety show. We have such a fun show tonight. We have a big guest from Las Vegas, Nevada, Ricky Bittman. I've known him for 1,000 years. I knew him back in Vegas when I used to work at the Damp Napkin as a cocktail waitress. And hold on 1 second. Yeah? No, the Winnebago. Yeah, that's a Winnebago. Yeah, no, no, that's my guest. No, he needs to park his Winnebago there. Well, I don't care if that's... that's not a handicapped parking spot. Come on. Come on. Can't you do this for me? Can't you just do this for me? It's not going to be that long. I like to break the rules. You know that. All right, see what you can do. See? Okay. I'm relying on you. See if you can make this work. Okay, don't call me again. Okay, bye. We're going to go to a quick break, and we'll be back.
It's P for park. Don't put the emergency brake on, because I'll forget. I don't want anyone smoking. Oh, hello. Ricky Bittman, up, up, and away, hey. I'm here backstage. We just parked a Winnebago out back, .21, and I'm heading inside to be on the Aunt Petunia Variety Show. Up, up, and away, hey. This brings a tear to my eye. I cannot wait.
Favorite on Petunia, and you're watching my variety show, and my guest is here. It's Rick Bittman. That would be this lovely gentleman right over here.
It's Ricky Bittman.
What did I say?
You said Rick Bittman. It's like that whole Ricky Nelson thing. Like, he wanted to be called Rick Nelson. I want to be called Ricky. That's okay, though. You know.
Well, it's embarrassing because I've known you for so long.
That's true. You know, you should have known Ricky Bittman. Two syllables, front
Ricky
and back.
Ricky Bittman. I really do. I've known him for a long, long time. We know each other from Vegas.
Vegas, the old days, the Damp Napkin, working the door. I mean, you're a funny lady. I was a funny man.
Yes.
TC and Bull, all of this stuff, it all ties in magically.
It all ties in magically. Now, listen, this is a variety show, and I brought you on because you're talented, but I want to put a pin in that for a moment.
Okay.
Because I want to talk about myself. I
just
know.
Like every other dame I've ever met in my life. That's fine with me.
I can hear my nephew TC already eyes rolling that I've moved.
The heck with him.
Yeah,
he's not here.
Go eat your orange Tic Tacs and get over yourself.
Yeah, and your tofurkey. God bless his heart.
Well, listen. Here's the thing. I've been doing a lot of research on the Royals, the royal family.
Yeah. Oh, I thought you were talking about the Kansas City Royals. Okay.
The
La Familia de Royale in England.
Yes.
Windsor Castle.
Yeah, and the thing is, you know how fun I am.
Of course. Who doesn't?
So I'm thinking Queenie needs a new friend. And I think that friend should be me. Look at the way I dress. I would fit right in.
You're very regal. That's the impression I'm getting right now. You have a regality that just exudes from you.
Yes.
Like that?
Yes, I like that a lot.
I could see you two as being girlfriends, girls' night out type of thing.
Right? I mean, we're not that different in age. I think she's she's a lot older than me.
Yeah, I think she's got about a good 90 years on you, so I would say.
Well, I'm 72.
Oh, jeez. As Jack Benny would say. Remember Jack Benny?
Yes, of course. But that's a mission that I'm on. And I'm just going to try and...
Well, how are we going to go about this?
I don't know.
Happen?
Like, I just want to, I just want to call her up.
She's got to be in the book. What is her last name anyway?
Windsor?
Is it really
Windsor? I don't know.
That's a good trivia question.
Clearly my research has left me a little blank on her name.
I know Prince Charles. I always thought that was his first name, Prince, like the singer.
But didn't you think it was odd that the brother was Prince as well?
That's true.
Prince Andrew?
Well, George Foreman, all of his sons were named George. So
yeah, so it's a thing.
Yeah. So I can,
People could do it.
I can back it up with that.
But now that we're talking, I'm looking at your getup, and that's got a regal tone to it too.
Well, I'm glad this is a genuine uniform from the Royal Order of Raccoons from the original Honeymooners classic 39 episodes. Jackie Gleason wore this jacket. This hat in the classic 39. I think the Royal Order of Raccoons appeared in maybe 4 episodes.
Okay.
And that was the lodge that he belonged to. And I knew I was coming tonight. I knew I was going to be in the presence of greatness. And I knew you dressed to the nines. And I got to be honest with you. With the thing we've been going through the past year that we're not going to mention.
No, we're not going to mention.
My wardrobe suffered a little. So the only thing I felt that could really make an impression tonight was this.
And you know what? It's so working that I'm thinking once, let me warm up Queen Elizabeth, and then we'll bring you.
Okay, that's fine. Right? No, I understand.
Yeah.
But I just don't know how we're going to go about this.
You don't
call her up and wait. Is she on Twitter?
We got to hatch a plan. Do you know anybody?
I know lots of people, but none of them hang out with her.
But are they British?
Doc McMurphy, maybe.
Ooh, Doc McMurphy.
He's a bona fide bum kisser. I mean, he's got to know somebody
that could get you at least past the front gate. Yeah, exactly.
I talk to him, but you know what? But the whole thing is, you know, you got to just do the whole girls' night out thing. You got to pitch it to her.
Yeah,
she's got to be on the Twitter.
I just think that she is a lot more fun than she lets out. Like she keeps it pretty tight, like with the brooch and the bag and the. Get her a few Pinot Grigios and let's see what happens.
A few of those Pinot Grigios in 5 minutes with you. I'm telling you right now, she's gonna be dancing on the table.
She's gonna be dancing and possibly dating.
Oh dear! Well, that's right. Her husband died. Well, now see, there's an opening right there.
There's an opening right there. I mean, she needs a companion. She needs a sidekick. She needs a wing, a right wing.
We both know a guy that's single, Bull Montana. You know, you never know. I mean, I'm just saying. I mean, he could really open her doors, her eyes to a lot of doors that she's never walked through before.
For sure. Definitely. For sure. But I think we're on to something.
Well, I think we got to make it happen.
Exactly.
You know, sometimes, you know what I hate? I hate, Petunia, I hate dry plans. I hate them. So if we're coming up with this scheme, we got to hatch it.
Well, what do you think? Like, do you think we do it kind of sneakily? Like we...
No, you go bold. You go right in the face.
You go right in the front of the
arm. You go right up to her and say, let's go out. Let's go out. Have some cosmos, all right? Let's do some karaoke.
Let's get maybe a jumpsuit on. Maybe something a little bit.
I love jumpsuits. Don't you love the 70s?
I loved the 70s.
And how old was she in the 70s? I mean, I don't even know. I mean, I'm terrible at math, but I'm sure she still remembers the 70s.
Of course she does, because she's 95. So,
oh, God, here we go, math.
I don't even know the math.
Maybe we'll say 40 years. So she's like in her mid-50s back then.
Completely appropriate to wear a pantsuit.
Sure.
Yeah.
I'm sure she listened to some Elton John back then.
I just think she needs to loosen up a little.
There's no question. Nowadays, she's got to loosen up. And if there's anyone that's going to do that, it's going to be you.
But do you think I maybe shouldn't wear my tiara or crown?
That's a good point.
Do you think I'm better off toning myself down?
Do you like the tiara?
I love it.
Then you got to wear it.
Okay.
Because otherwise you're not you.
Right.
Don't hide anything.
Right.
Put it all on the table. Bring it out. Say, this is who I am.
Yeah.
Love it or leave it. Like Archie Bunker used to say about this great state of the United States of America. If she doesn't like the tiara, then you weren't meant to be friends. Call Charo.
Love her.
There you go. That could be the next. What if once you get the queen all sewed up?
Then you call Charo. Yeah. And that's easy peasy.
Yeah.
Like, that's like going from here to here. I mean, I can do that.
I worked Charo's great-granddaughter's birthday party. I was in charge of piñatas. She ordered a plethora of piñatas for her great-granddaughter's birthday party, and I worked it. And you know who was working the florist that time?
No.
Giselle Bundchen.
No.
Yeah. Listen to Ricky Bittman's Jukebox, my podcast, and you'll find out the rest of that story.
That's a good one.
Sorry, a little shameless plug.
Yeah,
there,
a little plug. Listen to my
stuff room, you know?
Yeah, listen to my podcast while I drink my Bud Light.
A little spring water here.
The other thing is, we're not going to horse and buggy it, okay?
Oh, no.
We're going to Uber. She's going to get in an Uber.
Definitely. Why? What else would you do? I mean, the horses. You don't want to walk into a nightclub smelling like you've been riding a horse.
Right. And, like, none of this.
That's done.
The gloves are coming
off. That actually hurts.
So to speak. The gloves. Queenie is going to come out, in a jumpsuit, no gloves, dance her head off, drink it up. It's going to be great.
What kind of drinks do they drink in England anyway? What are they like? What's the Harvey Wallbangers and that type of stuff? What do you think she you know, I bet she gets a Brandy Alexander.
I think you're right.
John Lennon used to drink those.
I watched The Crown, and she had the Prime Minister, Margaret Thatcher.
Maggie.
And they were having she was having a rough day, Margaret, and Queen Elizabeth offered her a brandy. So maybe.
I think we're onto something.
You know what? Maybe I should start drinking brandy.
All it is brandy and milk, Brandy Alexander.
You is got, that right?
Quincy can hook you up with the, Quincy Briscoe can hook you up with the milk. I can get you the brandy for crying out loud. I got some of the Winnebago, so you're already halfway there.
I know. We haven't even gotten to the Winnebago.
Oh.
God. So when I knew Rick back in the day, he would travel around in his Winnebago, not to be confused with Winnebago.
That's right. That's right.
And
you got to pay money every time you say that name.
And you've upgraded it, I understand.
Well, TC and Abby Howich bestowed upon me this incredible upgrade because of, I don't know, you know, the time's gone by and they knew that the old Winnebago was kind of smelling like an old sneaker.
Yeah.
So I got up one morning.
Well, it smelled like an old sneaker when I
Now it smells like a really old sneaker.
Yeah, like a, yeah.
Yeah, you know, with the toe stick, little toe sticking out the side. So I go out one morning, and I'm, you know, okay, and I bought another little hang-up little Christmas tree to go put on the cigarette lighter, and I look up, and it's gone. And in its place is this magnificent Winnebago .21 for 2021. TC and Abby hooked me up, and you got to see the inside. It's got a pizza oven in it.
Oh, my God.
It's got a deep fryer, and it's got a hot dog maker.
Okay.
Because I'm not as healthy as TC. I mean, I still like to have fun.
Of course.
And I still like to eat.
Yeah.
So he hooked me up big time.
Okay.
So I'm going to give you the tour.
Okay. I love it. Oh, I love it.
I just traveled down to Kentucky Derby with that.
Did you really?
Down and back. 15 hours down, 15 hours back. Lost my shirt. But it was worth it.
I'm not sure. Was it worth it? I'm a little nervous. Did
it
you
was
lose
worth
a lot
it.
Of money?
I mean, okay. Listen to the podcast and you'll find out why. I took Bob Baffert to the cleaners.
Podcast.
All the trouble
podcast
he's in right
again.
Now. Ricky Bittman's jukebox. Available on Spotify only. I got some of that Joe Rogan deal going. Joe Rogan and I, exclusive with Spotify on Ricky Bittman's jukebox. Find out what I did to Bob Baffert because he's in a lot of trouble now. I sent an email to the Vatican.
Oh.
This is what they call a little teaser right now. That's a teaser.
That's a teaser. And the funny thing is, I have you on here because you are a singer. And you're going to be we're going to be singing later on.
Of course.
Because it's a variety show.
And we're going to be singing a song from the 70s.
We're going to sing our favorite.
The favorite. Best decade of all time, the
70s. Best decade of all time.
TC says the 80s, but I'm sorry, TC.
I'm sorry, too. Wrong. He's wrong.
Setentos. What do they say in Espanol? Ochenta is TC. Setenta is us. Pardon my French.
No, I love
it. Terrible
I love
Spanish.
It. All right, so you've got a song picked out for us.
I do.
All right, so we're going to go to a commercial break.
I love a commercial.
You're going to have another little sip.
Oh, there's no question about it. I'm definitely going to have another sip.
You're going to have a sip. And when we come back, we're going to sing a little ditty for you.
Mm-hmm.
Am I singing with you?
If you know the words, you sing right along with me.
Oh, I don't know the words. I'll just kind of...
Dance and be pretty.
I'll dance and hopefully catch Queen Elizabeth's attention.
Yeah. And if you feel inspired, just join in.
Okay, all right. Because I'm thinking maybe I could get a clip of this for her.
We're in the world now where you can just get this to her tomorrow morning.
Okay.
If you needed to.
Okay. Because I think I need to.
And whatever I can do to help you, just let me know. I know a lot of people that I don't even know I know.
I believe that. That makes sense
to me.
It's
true.
We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody, to Opportunia's Variety Show. That was just a little ditty. But the real singer is my guest, Ricky Bittman.
Ricky Bittman.
Ricky Bittman. Take it away.
Okay, thank you very much, Aunt Petunia. I can't believe I got the opportunity to sing again on live TV. Before I begin, I just want to mention to everybody, don't forget to check out Ricky Bittman's Jukebox. It's an exclusive deal on Spotify. You don't have to have the premium subscription. You can have a regular one, but you can only access Ricky Bittman's Jukebox on Spotify, just like the Joe Rogan deal. Okay? So, what I'm going to do for you now, I'm going to bring you a song direct from a future episode of Ricky Bittman's Jukebox. This is by Hurricane Smith, 70s song icon, what you would also probably call a one-hit wonder. Wow. And the name of the song is, Oh Babe, What Would You Say? Have I a hope for half a chance to even ask if I could dance with you? Yoo-hoo. Would you greet me or politely turn away? Would there suddenly be sunshine on a cold and rainy day? Oh, babe, what would you say? For there are you, sweet lollipop, and here am I with such a lot to say. Hey, hey, just to walk with you along the Milky Way, to caress you through the nighttime, brings you flowers every day. Oh, babe, what would you say? 'Cause, oh, baby, I know I could be so in love with you, and I know that I could make you love me too. And if I could only hear you say you do, ooh. But anyway, what would you say? Oh, I love the saxophone. Don't you want Petunia?
I love it. I love this whole thing.
I'm feeling it.
I can see that.
I'm loving it. Hurricane Smith. Big finish coming up. Big finish.
Big finish.
Yo-ho, baby, I know I could be so in love with you, and I know that I could make you love me too. And if I could only hear you say you do, ooh. Well, anyway, what would you say?
I don't know. I think I do know.
You know what this dance is called?
No.
The Proud Pickle.
You're bananas.
No, the pickle. Oh, I'm jonesing to get out on the stage again. I don't know about you, Petunia.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that warms the cockles of my heart. Oh, thank you for that opportunity.
That was just...
Oh, you're too kind. You're
oh,
too kind.
My goodness. That was something.
Oh, right from Ricky Bittman's Jukebox.
That's Ricky Bittman's Jukebox.
I'm drained. I'm actually drained.
Oh. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
Where's my producer, Galen?
Yeah, get him another beer.
Please.
Another
Listen,
Bud Light.
It, the pleasure is all mine. Anytime.
Okay.
Anytime I will be here.
Excellent. Excellent. You were a great guest.
It was a huge thrill.
It was a lot of fun. Mm. Yeah. I'll keep you posted on my project.
You know, you really should, because we've got to make it happen.
We've got to make it happen.
We've got all summer to do it, too.
I've got free time.
She's got to be running around that castle in her house coat with him not around anymore.
I'm thinking she's losing her mojo.
Yeah. You gotta snap her out of it.
I got to snap her out of it.
I could see the two of you like on one of those pedal bikes, you know, where they have the bar and you go, girls' night out. Girls' night out.
Girls' night out.
It's me, Aunt Petunia, here.
Yes.
Brandy Alexander, I hope I don't get sick.
Yeah, exactly. We'll probably take the bike, get some drinks, and then have to be picked up.
Uber?
There's your Uber. Throw the bike in the back. What are you going to do?
Right in the trunk.
Thank you so much for watching another Opportunia Variety Show. I'm thinking about trying to make a little ditty, like a little, you know, like a catchy little song.
Well, let's write one.
All right, let's do it.
My, you know, my catchphrase is, it brings a tear to my eye. Up, up, and away, hey!
We'll end with that.